Welcome to Legacy Garage by Mirik Studio. In this series, we present different ways of dealing with the most common challenges of software modernization. I'm Jagoda, Senior UX Designer at Mirik Studio.
And I'm David, Software Architect at Mirik Studio. In this episode, we are going to show you how to adjust your digital product to changing market needs. And don't worry, it won't be just a theory.
The basis for this video is our EdTech experience, and we will explain everything using an e-learning platform as an example. So what's the case? The product is an e-learning platform dedicated to around 300,000 registered schools with almost 15 million active users. It's created by the company that's been one of the EdTech market leaders for around 8 years. The main functionalities are about creating and solving tasks, conducting group classes, measuring progress, and presenting statistics for each task, group, and the whole school.
The company understands the need for implementing new technologies as their systems start becoming more and more outdated. On the other hand, they also seize the opportunity for business growth. Education is changing, and nowadays it's not limited only to schools and universities. To keep up with the market space and not stay behind the competition, the company needs to scale up and open itself for new customers. But of course, there are lots of challenges associated with this process. What's not working as it should be? Let's look under the hood and find out.
To identify the main challenges, find solution, and prepare a modernization roadmap, we need to follow a few steps of the pre-development process. Firstly, we focus on the project discovery stage. What we usually do to make the process of diving into existing product domains easier is overall product analysis. That means, for example, conducting some sort of audit, which is a review of the current interface and general user experience and comparing it with industry standards. We also try to use as much knowledge as we can from people that interact with the tool the most by conducting in-depth interviews with users or, for example, customer success representatives that mostly are aware of challenges that users meet the most. This step helps us point out the main business, design, and technical challenges. Let's start with the business part. The main business challenge is to determine the new brand identity. As you already know, the e-learning platform is no longer meant only for schools and universities. The modernization goal is to reach new clients from different industries like corporate customers or federal agencies. So the company needs to create and implement one consistent brand for communicating all new functionalities. What's important in introducing a new brand identity is keeping in mind the current product audience. Some of the changed interface components crucial for the current product, like dashboards or payment and transaction screens, are prepared in multiple versions, each modified gradually, to make sure rebranding will not impact existing users' mental models and habits. Another challenge is to set direction for the product development. Of course, we need to have in mind the current users' needs. We are adding new functionalities, but schools are still an important part of the product strategy. On the other hand, we also have to set the path for achieving the long-term goal, expanding the audience.
On the technical side, the biggest challenge was separating the e-learning content from the learning management system. The application was created when there was no primary e-learning interoperability standard on the market. Therefore, it contains many different capabilities, like the content management system, authoring tool, activity assessment, learning record store, schools, classes, and student management, analytics and reporting in one platform, created around one type of learning content. Unfortunately, this approach does not allow the solution to adapt new e-learning content without extensive development efforts. The second significant challenge is the poor performance of the learning record store and analytic tools that jeopardizes learning performance metrics. Without proper feedback about gaps in skills or knowledge, students doesn't have much chance to improve themselves.
Okay, so we've identified the main challenges of the project. Now let's focus on how to bring ideas into life. What are the solutions for modernizing this legacy e-learning system? There are a few key actions we need to take in order to set the modernization roadmap. From the UX perspective, we conduct the usability audit of the e-learning platform. The aim is to understand the product better and indicate the areas for improvement. We also prepare a deep EdTech market analysis to better understand the industry trends. At this step, we also conduct an extensive competition analysis which takes a form of a report gathering insights from the EdTech industry releases, direct and indirect competence functional benchmarking. The primary goal of this kind of report is to diverge the vision of future product's shape and ideate about the potential long-term product development milestones. After completing these steps, we can move on to planning the future vision. Here, we focus on creating the wireframes that are an outcome of the creative workshop sessions. During these sessions, armed with usability audit outcomes and the potential features and services researched during the trend analysis, we are able to converge ideas and shape them into more precise interface and UX recommendations. The goal is to visualize the functional solutions which we point out during the current state analysis.
The technical solution to pains that the platform had was simple and complex at the same time. We needed to define proper boundaries in the system and do a few strokes with the plasma cutter. We also had to separate these newly created components and apply the best solution for a particular purpose. To understand how much effort will be required, we conduct a detailed technology audit consisting of source code, database, infrastructure, and architecture review. Then, armed with that knowledge, we can define new architecture, including industry standards and robust components. For the LMS part, we add LTI and XAPI standards to allow interoperability with different e-learning content. In addition, we extract the learning record store to a separate service to enable easier integration with performance and reporting tools. This focus on the standards and responsibility separation gives us a free hand for solutions used to create and publish e-learning content. Content creators will not be forced to use only one authoring tool, and by using third-party solutions, we can reduce maintenance on our side. However, this doesn't block us from creating our own learning content management system for unique content. Every part of the application can evolve independently.
Okay, so that's how we find faults and prepare a detailed repair plan. By following the steps of the pre-development process, we can be sure the modernization will run smoothly.
Hope you liked it. If so, you'll find more Legacy Garage episodes on our YouTube channel. If you want to broaden your knowledge about software modernization, check out the link below.